This video will show you how to efficiently search for articles using subtopic keywords and search strings in the Web of Science databases, using BIOSIS Previews as an example. When you first access BIOSIS Previews, this is the interface you should see. It will look the same for all of the other Web of Science branded databases, so be sure you're searching in the correct one. If it says you're searching in something else, you can use the drop-down menu to select the correct database. My recommendation is to search each of your subtopics separately so you have an easier time combining them later on to find relevant research that may cover different aspects of your research question. For this example, I'm going to use the research question, "Does the drug dipyridamole reduce blood clotting in diabetic COVID patients?" This can be broken down into four subtopics: dipyridamole, blood clots, diabetics, and COVID-19. I'm going to take each of these subtopics and the keywords I generated for each, and I'm going to toss them into this basic search box using Boolean operators to separate them. Let's start with dipyridamole. Since these are related terms and I want to make sure I find articles that mention any of them, I'm going to separate them using OR as shown. Dipyridamole OR anticoagulant OR antiplatelet OR vasodilator OR aspirin. Now I'm going to run this search, but I'm not going to start looking through the results just yet. I'm instead going to go back to my basic search and start over with my next subtopic. The database will remember my search history, and I can come back to my searches when I'm ready. My next subtopic is blood clots, so I'm going to do the same thing I did before, toss all my related terms in and separate them using OR. I'll run this search, and I'll set the results aside just like before. I'm going to repeat this process for all of my subtopics, like so. Once all my subtopic searching is done, it's time to start combining them. This is done through the advanced search page. You'll see some additional search boxes here, but below that is where you'll want to look for your search history, called session queries in Web of Science. Each search that has been run in the current browser session will be listed here in reverse order, along with links back to the results they returned. Now you're ready to start combining. The checkboxes next to the search numbers will let you select the searches you want to combine, and once you've selected at least two, you'll be able to combine the sets. Here is where the Boolean operator AND is useful. I recommend selecting different combinations of subtopics and combining them with AND to see how they interact with each other in the literature. You don't want to start by combining all your search strings, as that will only return those papers that talk about exactly what you're researching. This is a great way to see if anyone else has done this research already, but it's not a great way to find background information and evidence pertaining to different aspects of your topic. Once you've combined your strings in different ways, you're ready to start looking through the results to find articles relevant to your topic.